They say these chains will never break, but they don't know you like we do. There is power in your name. We've heard that there is no way through. We've heard the tide will never change.
Yeah. Just like you did it before. Lord, we are ready for more. up your head, O ye gates, and be ye lifted up, you everlasting door, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Praise God. Good morning, and welcome to Kingdom Word Ministry, where we preach and teach the Word of God, chapter by chapter, verse by verse. Praise God. I'm excited this morning. The Lord has a word for this morning. Praise God. Are you excited this morning? Tell the Lord hallelujah. Tell the Lord thank you. Praise God. Good morning again. It's a beautiful day that the Lord has set aside for us to worship him on this glorious day. Praise God. So let's get right into the word. The word will be coming from 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 14 through 23, beginning at verse 14. But the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul, and the evil spirit from the Lord troubled him. And Saul's servant said unto him, Behold now, an evil spirit from God troubles thee. Let our Lord now command our servant, which is before thee, to seek out a man who is kind and plain, only hard. And it shall come to pass, when the evil spirit from God is upon thee, that he shall play with his hand, and thou shalt be well. And Saul said unto his servant, Provide me now a man that can play well, and bring him to me. Then answered one of his servants, and said, Behold, I have seen a son of Jesse, the Bethlehemite, that is cunning and plain, and a mighty valiant man, a man of war, and prudent in matters, and comely person, and the Lord is with him. Wherefore Saul sent messenger unto Jesse, and said, Send me David, thy son, which is with the sheep. Jesse took an axe laden with bread, and a bottle of wine, and a kid, sent them by David, his son, unto Saul. David came to Saul and stood before him, and he loved him greatly, and he became his armor bearer. And Saul sent to Jesse, saying, Let David, I pray thee, stand before me, for he has found favor in my sight. And it shall come to pass, when the evil spirit from God was upon him, Saul, that David took an harp and played with his hand. So Saul was refreshed and was well, and the evil spirit departed from him. Let us pray. Father God, thank you for another day, another opportunity to lift you up and to magnify your name. God, I ask you this morning that you have your way. Have your way with me, have your way with your listeners. God, give us that spiritual ear to hear and to understand your word. Because we're assured, God, this word falls on good ground, it will come up again. So let the words of my mouth and meditation of my heart be accepted in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer, and the body of believers said, Amen. Amen. Praise God. This morning, I'd like to talk to you from the subject, the five P's. Proper preparation prevent poor performance. God gives us proper preparation to prevent a poor performance this morning, praise God. I believe that out of those five words, the first two are the most important. The first two is the foundation to your success. When you look at proper and when you look at preparation, it talks about where you need to start and building a foundation towards your success. In our text here, we find that there are three names that will be mentioned here in this text, one being Samuel, the other being Saul, and the other being David. God used these people in preparing us to accept and understand the five P's. He began with the proper alignment with his servant, Samuel. He said to Samuel, he addressed Samuel in verse 1. He did not send someone to Samuel or for Samuel. He did not send another prophet. He did not send an angel. God came himself and addressed Samuel. Praise God. It was the proper thing to do. Praise the Lord. He not only addressed Samuel, but he had Samuel to address Saul. Even before he addressed Samuel in the last point that we're talking about here today, he addressed Saul first. Now he's addressing Samuel in verse 1. He said, how long will thou mourn for Jesse, for Saul, seeing I have rejected him from reigning over Israel? Fill thy horn with oil and go, and I will send thee to Jesse's Bethlehemite, for I have provided a king among his sons. God could have bypassed Saul. He could have bypassed Saul. He could have bypassed even Samuel, praise God. But God provided him to provide himself a king. God didn't need none of it. He could have just went on and provided himself a king, because God is in the providing business, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But God always does things decently and in order. It was the proper thing to do. 1 Corinthians 4:14-40 said, let all things be done decently and in order. The word proper, the word means to conform and to establish standards of behavior or manner. It's doing the right thing, doing the right way. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm reminded when I first got into coaching, and I met this coach, and he would begin to talk to me about things of coaching, and I saw them out there practicing, and I said, they're really practicing, and I know I've heard, and you've heard, that practice makes perfect. But he stopped me right there when I was talking about practice makes perfect. He said, practice does not make perfect. He said, perfect practice makes perfect. When we're doing it the right way, when we're doing it proper, when we're doing it in order, it becomes something that you can work toward having better skills, praise God, to help you along the way. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? It was hard, my brothers and sisters. It was hard for Samuel to do this. But God prepared him for this occasion, praise God. God said, I have provided me a king. Praise the Lord. He had provided for Israel. He had provided for Elijah. He had provided for Abraham. He had a ram tied in the bush for Abraham, praise God. God will provide for you whatever you need this morning, praise God. God will provide for you. How many know that this morning? God is in the providing business this morning, praise the Lord. Paul says in Philippians 4:19, he said, but my God. When Paul said my God, he makes this thing personal, because they had done something to Paul. They had done something for Paul. But Paul said, my God, I might not be able to, but my God shall supply all of the need. All of your need according to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus. Praise God. Whatever you need this morning, praise God, God is able to provide it for you. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? Even though you are doing the proper thing and you're doing it the right way, there still are concerns. God asked Samuel. He asked Samuel a question. He said, how long? How long will you mourn for Saul, seeing I have rejected him from reigning over Israel? How long? Samuel's heart was broken. His heart was broken over Saul's failure. After disobeying God, God told him to go down and destroy the Amalekites. Saul didn't do it. Now we have Samuel notifying Saul that the Lord has rejected him from being a king. Now we have that Samuel in a situation right now. He is so disappointed. He is greatly disappointed. He's mourning over Saul's failure. He could have been sitting back there gloating. He could have been saying, I told you so. I told you to go down and destroy all of the Amalekites. But no, his heart was heavy. That let me know we shouldn't be gloating over people that have fell on their face and have fallen from grace, praise God. We need to be praying for them. We need to be trying to lift them up, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Samuel was depressed. He was mourning. That let me know that the scripture tells it's all right to weep. It's all right to weep. It's all right. I don't know about you, but it's all right to weep. Jesus wept. Yes, he wept. But the question is to Samuel, how long? How long will you weep? The Bible said weeping may endure for a night, but joy is coming, praise God. How long, Samuel? I don't know how long. It might be a day, it might not be a day. But one thing we know, praise God, that joy is coming. Give me a hallelujah. Give us a glory to God. But at some point, we must say what have happened is in the past. It doesn't mean that you forget the person that you love and the present and the time you spend with him and all the things that God have done with you and that person together. But what it's saying to you now, that it's time to move on. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Says it. But at some point, praise God, at some point in our life, after mourning for a while, at some point in our life, we must go on. God told Samuel to it's time, praise God. It's time to go forward. Hallelujah. God said, go forward. Feel your horn, the Lord, and go. It's time to go forward. Fill your horn with the Holy Ghost. Fill your body with the Word of God. Whatever you're going to find scriptures, praise God, that can fill that void that's in your life and move on so God can use you this morning, praise God. God want to use you, but you're still mourning, praise God. Hallelujah. It's all right. It's all right, my brothers and sisters. It's all right. But at some point, we have to move on. Give us a hallelujah. Samuel was still concerned. And he was concerned. He was concerned about Saul finding out that he was going to anoint another king. He thought Saul would kill him if he found out. He had concern. And no matter who you are, fear will cause you to have some doubt. It will cause you to have some doubt, praise God. Whatever, whether or not you're a preacher, whether or not you're a man of God, a woman of God, or deacon board, or whatever, fear will cause you to have some doubt. But we must remember that wherever God has sent you, wherever he called you to go, God will fill the detail. He will fill out everything that you need, praise God, in order for you to meet that task. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? God had a solution, praise God. God had a solution for Samuel concern. He had a solution for Samuel fear. He said, Samuel, I'm going to put your fear to rest. You don't have to worry. And the solution concerning this issue, I will conceal my plan. So concealment was not a deception. It was God's authority to conceal the thing, praise God. We look at Proverbs 25 and 2. Proverbs says, it is the glory of God to conceal a thing. Hallelujah. But the honor of kings is to search out a matter. Praise God. God said, it's my authority to do what I do. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But it's your job as a person to search out the matter, to see whether or not it's right, see whether or not it's true, see whether or not it's proper. Praise God. See with the proper things to do. Sometimes we must not let our left hand know what our right hand is doing. The proper thing to do is to obey the command of God. Samuel was commanded to find a man of God to be the king, to known as king. Samuel went to Jesse's house to find a man to anoint as king, praise God. God did not tell Samuel, nor did God tell Jesse who he was going to know, what son he was going to know as king. God has a reason for what he does, praise God. Whatever he does is good and very good, praise God. God has a lesson here for Samuel. And not only for Samuel, for Jesse too, praise God, because it was Jesse's son. Jesse brought his first son before Saul. Eliab. Samuel said, surely when his son walked before him, he said, surely the Lord anointed is before me. Surely the Lord is anointed is here. Samuel was looking at the appearance. He was looking at the height. He was looking at the stature. He was looking at the outward appearance of the person that was in front of him. He looked right. He tall. He had everything that he should be. Right? praise God, hallelujah, from the outside. But God said in verse 7, a text, he said, but the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance, on the height of his stature, because I have refused him, I have rejected him. He's not the one. For the Lord sees not as man sees. For man looketh on the outward appearance, but God, he looks on the heart. Praise God. You can't judge a book just by looking how pretty it looks on the outside. When you open it up and read it, you begin to understand a little bit more what all those things on the outside was all about. It's the same with a person, praise God. Once you are able to look on the inside, and man cannot look on the inside, only God can look on the inside. We look at people in their face, and what we see in their face is not what that person is all about. Only that person and God knows what's on the inside. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? Jesse brought all of his sons out, and the oil did not flow. He brought them all. They looked good. They looked great. They looked like everything. Surely one of them should be the man that God wanted to anoint because they had the stature. They had the look. But the young son, he asked the question, are these all your sons? He said, there's one in the field working with the sheep. He's a shepherd. He's working with the sheep. Samuel wanted to see him. Samuel wanted to bring to him the young son who was in the field. He was in the field working on his craft. He was in the field not complaining. He was in the field doing what he was supposed to do. And he had joy and he had peace while he was, praise God. He was working on his craft, praise God. He was being overlooked because he didn't look like. He wasn't looked upon as favorable as the brother was looked upon. His stature was not there. No one, praise God, thought you would be anything. No one looked at you. Everybody passed you out because you wasn't dressed right. You wasn't looking right. You didn't have everything intact. But God doesn't look at the outward appearance. God looks at the heart. God saw the best in you, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. People judge you from the outside appearance. They may overlook your value. Individuals who lack the physical appearance that the world lacks, they are looked over, praise God. But God sees the heart. He knows what's in the heart. While everyone can see your face, it's only you and God, praise God, that knows what's on the inside. Give us that thank the Lord. What steps are you taking this morning to improve your heart attitude this morning? Praise God. Hallelujah. We see in our text this morning, verse 13, God began to make preparation for David to be king. He've already done the proper thing, but now he's taking the preparation that is needed for David to be king. We see in verse 13, Samuel took the horn of oil, anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. I like what it said here. He anointed him in the front of his brother, right in the midst of his brothers, praise God. That let me know that sometimes God will put you right in the place where you need to be to let everybody know they pass you by. But God saw the best in you, praise God. Hallelujah. Sometimes God will anoint you and he'll bless you right in the presence of your enemy, praise God. Psalm 23:5 tells us, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemy. God will put his table right in the presence of the enemy, praise God, and let them know that he's in charge. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? Thou anointed my head with oil. My cup's running over. God is flowing his blessings upon you right in the front of your enemies. You don't have to be up there trying to fight your battle. God is already fighting your battles. Can we say thank you, Lord? Even though David was anointed king, he was not ready to be a king. He was not ready to be put in that position. You might be promoted on your job. You might be promoted to a new position. But the question is, are you prepared? Are you ready for your new position? The word preparation mean, the word preparation mean an act of preparing. It's about training. It's about being ready, praise God. God was working things out behind the scene, praise God. You might not know that God is working things out, but God is working things out for your good behind the scene, praise God. He was working, praise God. Hallelujah. The scripture says in Romans 8:28, we look at it from the NLT version. It said, God calls everything to work together for the good of those who love God. We're called according to his purpose for them. God has a purpose for you, and he's working behind the scenes. He's working things out. You might not know that he's working things out, but he's working things out this morning. You would say, hallelujah. He's doing all things well for you, praise God. Hallelujah. Working it together, praise God. Right where you are, he's working it. Tell the Lord, thank you. He's working it out, praise God. God called the Spirit to come upon Saul in verse 14. Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul, and an evil spirit from the Lord troubled him. Before you can take your position in your place in life, there need to be preparation made for your position. Not to put you in a position that you don't know nothing about. Not to put you in a position to fail. You need to be prepared for the position that you're getting ready to take. So think it not strange, my brother and sister, where you are right now. What God has you in right now. Think it not strange where you are. What are you doing where you are? Are you working, praise God? Because God is working behind the scene for your new position, praise God. Whatever you're doing this morning, praise God. Do it with some zeal. Do it with some joy. Give us a hallelujah. It doesn't matter whether you're working at McDonald's or Burger King or even on a garbage truck. It doesn't matter. Learn and prepare yourself while you are there. Because one day you might own that franchise, praise God. Or God might have you elevated to run that position. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Work while you're there, praise God. Learn while you're there. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? See, David, he was a shepherd boy. But he was learning how to be a leader. He wasn't just leading the sheep. He was learning how to be a leader. Shepherd leads sheep. He was being prepared for his destiny, praise God. God was working with him behind the scenes for his good. God was working for him to get him ready for his new position. He did not know it, but God was working on his behalf. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Evil spirit troubled Saul. He was troubled. This is how God opened the door for David. God called the spirit, his spirit, to leave Saul. And an evil spirit from the Lord troubled him. Even though David was not officially made king, God was working behind the scene, praise God, on behalf of David. He was making preparation to be king. The servant, praise God, of Saul, they noticed Saul unrest, praise God. Somebody, praise God, that's in your corner, they know when you're going through. They know that you're putting on a facade. They know you're trying to be strong. And they're concerned, praise God, what you're going through this morning, praise God, hallelujah. But look what happened, praise God. God opened the eyes of Saul's servants so they could see, hallelujah, the next move for David. Verse 16 said, let our Lord now command our servant which are before thee to seek our man who is cunning plain on the heart. And it shall come to pass when the evil spirit from God is upon thee that he shall play with his hand and thou shalt be well, praise God. David's servant noticed his troubled spirit. They noticed his unrest. And they knew that music soothes the heart. Music soothes the troubled heart, praise God. It was a time when music was real. It was a time when you can play music, praise God, and it'll put you in a different mood. It will put you in a pleasant mood, praise God. But the music they play right now, I know I'm old-fashioned, but the music they play right now will want me to jump out of the window, praise God, not become, praise God, hallelujah, glory to God. But when you can't get get that song, make that melody in your own heart. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? You see, David was known for his shepherding skills. He was known for his bravery and also for his accomplishment as a harpist and a musician. David had no idea what he was doing as a shepherd would give him an open door to his future. God is looking at you. He's watching you to see whether or not you're working, to see whether or not you're taking what he's given you and bearing it and not taking what he's given you and doing the proper thing to prepare yourself for your next move. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say glory to God? See, Saul agreed. Saul agreed with his servant. God has a way of changing a person's heart in your favor, praise God, even though they don't know they're blessing you, praise God. Verse 17 tells me that Saul said, prove me now a man that can play well. Saul ordered for a musician to be found. And I like the fact that he said one that can play well, but notice he did not say one that can play the harp that's great. He was the best playing the harp. But he said, one that can play well, praise God. Where you are right now, work on your skills, praise God, and God will elevate you, praise God, because you are faithful, praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He said, just be working and let God do the rest. God will do the rest. You do your part, and God will do the rest with his money. The servant of Saul was impressed with this young man who just happened, praise God, to be anointed the next king of Israel, praise God. But his kingship was concealed. It was not known to the public. Someone this morning, my brothers and sisters, are watching you work. You may never know that somebody, someone is watching you, but someone is watching. It was no accident that David was in this position. God was working behind the scenes on his behalf. God is working behind the scenes in your life, praise God. You are getting ready. Are you getting ready this morning, praise God? Are you being prepared? Are you being the best that you can be this morning, praise God? Or are you sitting there complaining? Or are you sitting there moaning, praise God? God put David in this position to prevent David from failing as king. Are you being prepared where you are this morning? Praise God. Hallelujah. The word prevent means to avoid failure, to hinder from doing something. Praise God. God is preparing them to be what will prevent them from being successful. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Verse 18 of our text. Answered one of the servants and said, behold, I have seen a son of Jesse, the Bethlehemite, that is cunning and plain, a mighty valor man and a man of war, prudent in matter and a comely person, and the Lord is with him. God has given David favor, have granted David favor. He gave them unmerited favor, praise God. It was given by God. See, sometimes you don't know that God is favoring you, praise God. David was being favored by God. He was put in a position to be successful. God was working things out, praise God. He had him there. He called the heart of the servant, praise God, to go to Saul. Praise God. Sometimes God lays on your heart, on the person's heart that's in charge, in that position to move on your behalf. Can we say hallelujah? Give us a glory to God. See, David was a faithful shepherd boy. God was working. He was working with him. David was put in this position to prevent the enemy from using the excuse that he wasn't qualified. What better place to be qualified than to be actually under the king, and you are going to be a king, praise God, hallelujah. Glory to God. David could have been running around and said, oh, I'm a king. I ain't got to worry about this. I'm a king. No, David did exactly what the Lord opened the door for him to do. He was learning where he was. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God saw sent a messenger unto Jesse in verse 19. He sent that message. and said, send me David, thou son, which is with the sheep. Praise God. Sending him to me. He's out there with the sheep. I'm not getting somebody that's in the corporate office. I'm getting somebody that's working in the sheep, somebody that nobody knows nothing about, somebody that nobody respects. I'm going to get somebody because I know this person is committed to working where he is. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Verse 21 said, David came to Saul. He came to Saul and stood before him. And he loved him greatly. He became his armor bearer. Praise God. God put him in that position. Praise God. He prepared him. He did the proper thing. He was doing the proper work. He was there making preparation, praise God, to prevent him, praise God, from performing, praise God, poorly, hallelujah, glory to God. David was loved, and he was put in that position to learn the proper preparation to prevent him from having a poor performance this morning, praise God. You are put in your position, praise God. You're put in the proper position, the proper preparation to prevent you from failing, praise God. Are you working where you are? Are you doing what God asked you to do this morning, praise God? The problem was Saul. He saw what about David, but he didn't know the love that was in David that made him look good, that made him sound good, was from God, the law that he did not obey, praise God, hallelujah. You may be overlooked this morning. Or somebody looking at your physical appearance, but instead God sees the heart and he has you in the right place at the right time, praise God, hallelujah. Give us a glory to God. Saul's invitation presented an excellent opportunity for Saul to work towards his future, to work toward, at first hand, he was in the right place, he was under the king, and what better experience would you have than being under the position that you are one day going to be? You're going to feel that seat, praise God. Hallelujah. See, sometimes people put you in a position just to fail. But God said, a proper preparation prevent poor performance this morning, praise God. David was put in the proper position. He was put there having a good background, good foundation. Made preparation, praise God, to be king. Give us a hallelujah. Give us a glory to God. Verse 22 and verse 23, he says, and Saul sent to Jesse, saying, let David, I pray thee, stand before me, for he has found favor in my sight. He found favor in the sight of Saul. Stand before him. See, it's a way when you stand before somebody, not drop shoulders, but standing there proud, confident, knowing that you are a child of God. And God is working things out. He's behind you. He's with you. He's in front of you. He's on side of you. He's walking with you. Praise God. Hallelujah. David stood before him. Before he even got there, the Lord had already favored him. The Lord had already laid on Saul hard about David, praise God, hallelujah. And he did that and he made him an armor bearer, praise God. David was able to walk with Saul, to walk through with him and protect him and do all the things that he needed to do and learn the kingship, praise God, hallelujah. Glory to God. The scripture said in verse 23, it said, came to pass when the evil spirit from God was upon Saul, that David took an harp and he played with his hand. So Saul was refreshed and was well. The evil spirit departed from him, praise God. Sometime, praise God, hallelujah, we have to let go our plan that God, you thought God had approved you to have. And you let it go to move in his position, praise God. Yes, David was a shepherd. But God said, let it go. I'm getting ready to make you a shepherd over a nation. I'm getting ready to lead people, praise God, hallelujah. Be like David. We need to be like David. We need to wait and work patiently and feverishly on your skills where you are. Can we say hallelujah? He chose to learn and grow in the present of his circumstance. Can we say hallelujah? Whatever you want, praise God, God can give it. He will provide for you from having a poor performance, praise God, hallelujah. It was many years later that David was ready to be king, but God had prepared him to be ready for that position. He took the proper preparation to prevent you from having a poor performance. Let God have his way. Let God have his way in your life this morning, praise God. If you don't know him this morning, you don't know him as your personal savior, you don't know, and God is not moving in your life, and you're working in some place, or you're doing something, and you don't think that God is watching you, you need to just ask God to come into your life, praise God. If you don't know him this morning, ask him to come into your life and repent of your sin. Believe in your heart that God sent him to earth to die for your sin this morning, praise God. It's all about the cross. It's all about Jesus' death. He died so that you might have a right to the tree of life. He hung on the cross and died, took on your sin, took on your curse for you, praise God, because it was appointed unto man once to die, but Jesus died. Hallelujah. And just stay. Give us the hallelujah. Glory to God. He hung his head on that cross, and he died. Oh, Father, it's finished. It's all over. I've done what you asked me to do. And he put him in a borrowed tomb. And he was there 3 days and three nights. And God raised him up, praise God. He came out of that tomb. And there was the saints behind, because the saints could not go out first. Jesus had to be the first fruit of the dead. And once Jesus walked out, the other saints walked behind. Now he sits on the right hand of the Father. Saying, glory to God. He's making intercession for us. Praise God. Hallelujah. You could have that peace. You could have that joy. You could have the proper preparation to prevent you from having a poor performance this morning. Praise God. Let God have his way. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you. We thank you for this word. We thank you for another opportunity, God, to break bread with your people this morning. I pray, God, that this word will bless someone out there. That they've looked at these five P's, the proper preparation to prevent poor performance this morning, God. They've taken these words in heart, and they're preparing themselves and developing their skill for their future, God. I pray this, God. God, I pray this morning, God, that you would bless those, God, that are going through COVID or going through whatever they're going through, whatever the issue may be, loved ones. Someone is concerned, praise God. I pray this morning, Lord, that you give them a spirit of comfort this morning, praise God. Assurance this morning, praise God. And God, we need you to watch over this world and help us, God, to be able to come together and be one in the body of believers, in the body of Christ, God. God, we give you the praise and we give you the glory. In your son Jesus' name, in the body of believers this morning, said amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If this word, praise God, has been a blessing to you this morning, praise God, just feel free to text us. Let us know, praise God, that God has blessed you. You being blessed by the program, praise God. You being blessed by what's said. If some word has been said for you this morning that you have been blessed by, praise God, let us know. Praise God. Praise God. And if you want to be a blessing to Kingdom Word, praise God. You can be a blessing by just texting Kingdom Word to 225-25, praise God. And remember, Jesus Christ is Lord.